I had a few people suggest that I do a battery test between multiple smartphones. So I have 11 high-end smartphones set up in front of me on my desk. The iPhone SE, iPhone 6, LGG5, Galaxy S7, LGV10, Note 5, Lumia 950XL, Blackberry Priv, Sony Xperia Z5 Premium, Nexus 6P, and the Huawei Mate 8. I also have lined them up in order from smallest battery to largest battery. In a perfect world, the phone with the smallest battery would die first. But as we all know with smartphones, there are a lot of variables that go into battery life, like operating system, background apps, screen size, and screen brightness, and a lot of other variables. Most of these phones are unused. The iPhone 6 was used for a little bit, and the Note 5 was used as my main phone for about 6 months. For this test, all of the phones are in airplane mode with the screen brightness turned all the way up. I have a video that I made recently looping on all of the devices. I took a Han Solo Star Wars Lego and turned it into solid gold with the help of a goldsmith, which then fights Darth Vader. Pretty awesome video that you should check out after you're done watching this one. I'll have it linked in the cards and in the video description of this video. Here, have a listen for a second. The Nexus 6P wouldn't auto-rotate, so I had to turn it off and turn it back on again after starting the test. It had a few minute late start, but you'll see at the end of this video that a few minutes won't matter. Make sure you're subscribed so you won't miss any of my future tests, and let's see the results of this battery test. The first phone to die was the Sony Z5 Premium, just before the 4-hour mark. My theory as to why this phone died first is because it's the only phone with a 4K resolution on my desk at the moment. The video that is looping on all of the phones is in 4K, so the Xperia Z5 is pushing 4 times as many pixels as the rest of the phones, which are playing the video at lower resolutions. So it's okay that it died first in my mind because of how powerful that screen is. I imagine that in other tests that don't involve video, this phone would have lasted a lot longer. The next phone to dim and putter to a stop was the LG V10. When I turned on each phone, I left running any apps that turn on with the phone automatically, so I could be fair across all the devices. Unfortunately for the LG V10, one of the stock apps that auto-starts is the useless, battery-sucking Lookout app. This was disappointing. I had high hopes for the V10, and it finally died at 4 hours and 11 minutes. The next phone to die completely was the iPhone 6. This has one of the smallest batteries, so I was not surprised. Did you know that the iPhone 6S actually has a smaller battery than the iPhone 6? Someone should let Apple know that they're headed in the wrong direction with battery capacity. There is a big gap between the third and the fourth phone. The Microsoft Lumia 950XL died at 5 hours and 6 minutes. The Nexus 6P did legitimately die at 5 hours and 20 minutes. Then the LG G5 stopped playing video and pretended to be dead with 16% battery life at 5 hours and 21 minutes. Trying to screw up my test, but after checking the battery history, it was on course to die at the 6 hour and 15 minute mark. I'll have it scored correctly at the end of this video. The iPhone SE died at 5 hours and 33 minutes. Even though it has a small battery, it also has the smallest screen, so the battery doesn't get used as hard as the other phones, which means it can last longer. The Note 5 was the next to go at 6 hours and 20 minutes of screen on time. The BlackBerry Priv was the 9th phone to die at a very impressive 6 hours and 35 minutes. The Huawei Mate 8 has the largest battery in the group, but it also has the largest screen. It was the 10th phone to die at 6 hours and 38 minutes. The last phone to die was the Galaxy S7, with an impressive 7 hours and 1 minute of video playing. Remember that all phones are in airplane mode with the screen brightness turned all the way up. Here's a list of all the phones and how long they stayed alive. Let me know what you think of the results down in the comments. If you enjoyed this video and want to see more like it in the future, hit that thumbs up button and subscribe. Let me know in the comments what tests you would like to see done next. I do phone giveaways sometimes through my Twitter, so bounce on over there and see if I have anything going on at this time. Thanks for watching. Hope to see you around.